So that's what that looks like. These red film glasses, they block out blue and green light. These you can buy from the internet. There's a certain brand I can leave a contact about. I had insomnia for about 10 years. These glasses made an instant difference when I heard about them. So most people know about blue light being not good. Delays melatonin secretion in the brain to go to sleep. There's less, the deep sleep is less. I did a lot of reading about this sort of stuff, but not many people know that the green light is just as bad. It's just not known about yet. So these ones with the red filter, they block out the red, sorry, the green and the blue light. I don't wear them as much as I used to. I don't seem to need to as much. But at one stage, I was putting in as soon as I finished work, as soon as the sun went down, put these on, and the first night I wore these, I slept an hour 40 minutes longer, and the sleep felt deeper, and I woke up actually feeling refreshed, and that was after a decade or more, and the only thing that changed was this here. I'm on screens quite a lot too, so I highly recommend that if you want to build up energy levels. That's why I'm mentioning it. You want to sleep better, energy levels. Ties in very well with the orientation of Jum Jum. Bring your knees together, bending the knees back and forward. So we're doing a new posture. We're moving more into one-legged postures and a lot more weight on one leg compared to the other. So we definitely want the knees working well, lubricated, ready to take weight through them. And gradually, as you get better at this, you can sink lower. And the key thing is that you're still heavy in your heels. Then come up on the toe like that. So you're just bending the big toe, making the instep flat here. This one flat. Up, circle so your toe stays on the ground. Make the knee do a circle, and ultimately, you're making the ankle circle the other way. Other leg, toe stays, keeps touching the ankle circles. The other way. Okay, we're going to do quad squats. So let's just squeeze the butt a couple of times. So your feet are a little bit turned out, about 10 degrees. Legs are straight, bit of a twist sensation through the feet. Squeeze your butt hard as you can. And you may find you get a little bit sore, like DOMS. Delayed onset muscle soreness in your butt after doing just a few of these contractions, and let it go. Let everything be loose in your hips and your legs. Screw the feet around again, squeeze the butt. So you really can feel really hard in the butt. So we're just activating those muscles. Let it go, let everything be loose. Feet straight. Circle. So the head stays in the center, your body stays facing square. So I'm not trying to turn here, facing square. It's like I'm inside a cylinder here, and I'm cleaning the inside of the cylinder with my hips. So we'll do a set of quad squats. So I'll bend the knee, bend the hip. I just sink to where it's comfortable for me. I'm not pulled back here. Let the arms relax forward. I'm not locking out my joints. Just relaxing my legs, quads, calves, feet. As much as my knee goes forward, my hip goes back. So that's key cue at the start. And the body will naturally like lean forward a little bit in the torso. That's normal. And if you have really long femurs, really long thigh bones, or really short Achilles tendons, you'll find that you'll be leaning more. So some of you may be able to sink all the way. Don't do it if your body's tightening up. So I can sink all the way down and stay really relaxed. Been doing this for a long, long time. So if I felt like I started to tighten up, I would stop just here. But I still can relax my quads, I can relax my feet, and it gives me more range. Do just five more. So my knees stay in line with my big toe, even the second toe. They don't drift in at all. Bring the torus in. So being aware of the energy field around your body, letting the energy flow in through the top of the head, down into the belly, out through your feet. It's like it opens up under the ground, circulates back around, front, back, sides. And all you focus on now is just in the top, out the bottom. Energy in the top, out underneath the ground. As you breathe, just focus on your skull and your spine, all the way to your tailbone. The skull and the spine, focusing on the bones. Focusing on the spine becoming flexible. So it's softening. Softening anywhere that's too rigid, stiff, feeling old. As we breathe and focus, softening, flexible. And we're balancing that with strength. So we want a strong, flexible spine. And the skull is part of the spine. Strong, flexible spine. So as you're breathing, we're just letting any cobwebs, there might be the idea of like metaphorical cobwebs inside your spine. Like you're looking down the spinal column, where the spinal cord goes. We're just clearing energy right inside the spinal column. Connecting it now into the feet, so in through the head, down the spinal column, connecting into the feet, out the ground. And we're just bringing forward a colour, so pouring that colour down through the skull, through the spine, down through the legs, letting it fill your arms as well. And it's whatever colour comes to you. So we're just using the intuition here. It might even be a few colours. We're just being open to whatever colour is needed. So the colours coming to me, they're changing quite a bit. So they're coming in waves. And just one more. And sinking down into the whatever height you want to train at, holding this very yin position here, hands like suction cups, spine vertical. Just being aware of this area of the pelvis here, especially into the back of the pelvis, around the tailbone and sacrum. And we're imagining like a coil moving upwards, up through the center of the body, including the spine. Whatever color it wants to be, up through the top of the head, connecting above the head. Usually about a meter above the head, where your intuition wants to. Wants it to disappear. And we're being aware of above the head. So the moment my awareness is about here, there's something going on here. And then we be aware of below the feet. Just directly below your feet, just under the earth a little bit. And then send the awareness down further, about a meter below. So we're just bringing balance to the, what's called the heaven and the earth, and us as the human in the middle, we're balancing the energies of heaven and earth. So our own heaven and earth, yin yang energies, up down energies. and letting this point here relax. So in the shoulders nest, there's a little bit of an indent just under the collarbone, a bit of an indentation here. Letting that relax, let it soften. You might find your shoulders come forward a little bit, they just relax forward. And then feeling down into the quad here, letting here soften. Don't have to sink lower, but it's like it feels softer. The connection to the ground gets better just because we're softening tension. Then we let the arms drift up. And we're going to move from here and return back to here. So the arms are just resting on the ball, the energy ball, the balloon. And we shift the weight and let the body turn as we've been doing. So a really key thing with this whole series from now, the knee stays over the big toe, doesn't turn in at all. And we're still sitting in the quad, in both quads, but the body is oriented. So my hips gone from facing front to facing about 10, 15 degrees over here. And the hands are still in front of my body, so I haven't done this. I'm not doing this kind of motion. My arms look like they move, but they don't. It's my torso and hips that are shifting. The arms are always in the front here. So I've got that there. Spring the knee, spring the hip. Feel the pressure go through the foot into the tripod of the foot. Then from here I shift, body turning. Just a little bit of a turn. So we just want small turn. We don't need maximum turn here. Check the knee, spring, relax, keep relaxing here. So we're routing force all the time down into the foot, into the ground. And we're still soft in the arms. Shift again. Good. From here, we pivot this foot here on the toe. About 45 degrees. We lift the heel, so there's just pressure in the ball of the foot, and we make it that we have about 90 to 95% weight on this leg. So we're still here. So the knee's still in line with that big toe. Often it wants to drift in. Keep it open. And from here, this arm pushes up. Actually, what we'll do is we'll do this together. Push up into the third posture. So it's that kind of idea. So we're here, that arm now pushes up, like the third posture. This arm goes out, so it's like the fourth posture, this one. So we have both of those postures going. This arm's in line with this foot. And this hand here is in line with the other foot. So from the front, I've got that. Here, so it's just over. The elbow's tucked in a little bit here, not pointing out. And I feel my leg frying right now. So it's good if you feel your leg frying, it's good. And my eyes are just inside my knee here. Yeah, so I'm not here or over here, just inside there. And I've just changed my posture, so I'm gonna come back. So I'm gonna angle this foot again. Come back to center, back to the embrace the tree. I'm gonna push this arm out. So maybe we'll do the footwork first. So we shift the weight, got that turn, pivot on the ball of the foot. 90, 95% weight here, still springy. The heel lifted, so there's no weight in the heel on this side. Feeling the tripod here. Come up into the third position. Drop this one, and this one usually has to come over a little bit. So this arm's in line with my foot where it points. This one's in line where this foot here is pointing. So there's almost like there is a sense of pushing out here, like you're resting your hand on a ball, streams running through. You're not letting the ball swim away, float away. And you relax into here. So relax into this posture. You may find you've gone a bit low. Come up a little bit. As long as there's still a bit of a bend here, bending your knee. Don't have to go too low. For me, this is comfortable here. And we come back to center, pivot that foot back here. If you need to have a rest with the arms, rest with your legs, do that. Let you capture your breath, but we're still in it. The mind's still engaged with the practice here now. And we'll do one more set. So we sink, let the arms come up, let them float up. We transfer the weight, bit of a turn with the body, pivot on that ball of the foot, heel lift, separate the hands. And here, I'm not like this. As soon as we get into one-legged posture, the body wants to do this. It's called an extension pattern. Most bodies have it, and it's actually a pattern of stress, especially chronic stress. So I'm here, but I've relaxed here. This part's sunken. Or I can think about the Tian Tu point here, the notch of your throat. That part, when you breathe out, if you do a big sigh, it depresses a bit here, it sinks. We want that position. So we've got that there. So I'm relaxed, vertical spine, not leaning forward, not leaning back, not leaning sideways, totally vertical. Head over shoulders, shoulders over waist, and that over hips, and then the hips are over the feet. Got that vertical axis there. And that's called zone stacking. Do with the mind here, we aim to relax the mind, let the mind be calm. If it starts to get too crazy, then it's time to change position. Relax the mind, keep relaxing the body, not letting tension build up. Tension builds up way faster in these more one side weighted postures, so be aware of that. So we just relax, come back to center, pivot on that toe, let everything sink again. Any tension that's gone up on the out breath, let it sink. We shift, turn, pivot on the heel, separate hands, tuck that elbow a little bit. Another visual that you can use just momentarily, you've got a strap from here coming around your neck, connect onto this wrist. So that strap around your neck to your wrist. It's helping you hold the arms there. Resting on a ball here. Still got the big balloon chair. Sitting on the balloon chair. Whole foot taking your weight here. The heel lifted this side. And let's come back to center. And close. Breathing in, breathing out, dredging the channels, any tension that's in the body, anything unsettled. Moving down to the feet. Breathe in. In through the top of the head, following it down through your body. Clear anything that feels erratic, stirred up. Letting it calm. And we're back to this posture. Bring the hands over the belly button. dedicate the entire merit of this practice to the enlightenment of all beings in all places and all times. May this practice strengthen the body and the direction of all those engaging. May it be a gift to the world.